Good morning. We can discuss about third module, that is under fluid mechanics. Third module is fluid dynamics. So in this fluid dynamics, so basically fluid dynamics, in the sense the study of the fluid is in motion, right, by considering the pressure forces which makes to move the fluid, right? So I think in the previous chapter already we have studied about fluid kinematics. So that is the study of the fluid is in motion, so without considering the pressure forces. But under fluid dynamics we'll consider the pressure forces which makes to move the fluid, right? So in this, under fluid dynamics, the very very important topic under fluid mechanics subject we use, so that is Euler's equation of motion, right? So, and also Bernoulli's equation. So by making use of Euler's equation of motion, the Bernoulli's equation is derived. So this is very very important concept under fluid mechanics. So in this we have before deriving the Euler's equation or Bernoulli's equation, so there are some assumptions. Based on that assumptions only, the Euler's equation, thereby Bernoulli's equation is derived. So the first assumption is the fluid is ideal fluid. Ideal fluid in the sense, so that is having no viscosity and which is incompressible, right? The fluid which is having no viscosity. There is no viscosity. That type of fluid is called as ideal fluid. So the flow is continuous, the flow is steady, the flow is incompressible, the fluid cannot be compressed, and there's a laminar flow of fluid, means the fluid flows smoothly, all right? So in the sense, like it doesn't crosses any path, all right? So it moves in the single path, the same path it moves without disturbing the adjacent layer. So that is the flow is laminar flow. So the flow is irrotational, it doesn't rotate in its own axis, all right? And also the fluid is subjected to pressure force and gravity force. So in this, so we assume the two forces which are acting when the fluid is analyzed or when the fluid flows, so that is pressure force and gravity force. Yeah, so can start with the derivation. So here, to derive, initially they have derived Euler's equation of motion. To derive Euler's equation of motion, so they have considered a small fluid element. So whatever you can see here, 1 minute. Yeah, so whatever you can see here, so this is the fluid element, all right? So this is the fluid element. It is cylindrical in shape. This is the fluid element. So this is cylindrical in shape. So they have considered a small cylindrical fluid element, all right? And they have assumed the fluid is flowing in some direction, say S direction. So they have taken the direction as S, the random direction. So they have taken as S direction. All right, and it has got the length of the fluid element is ds. So ds is the length of the fluid element, all right? And the height of inclination, so is considered as dz. So it has got the inclination as dz, and also this fluid element has got the self weight. So self weight, so weight is denoted by capital W, right? So capital W, in the sense we know the formula for specific weight. So specific weight is the ratio of weight per unit volume, right? Or weight is equal to specific weight into volume. So here specific weight can also be denoted by small W. So here they have denoted it by gamma, okay? So but you can take the denotation as small W also. All right, specific weight into volume gives you the weight of the fluid element. All right, So volume is area into length, right? So area of the fluid element is considered as dA, right? And the length of the fluid element is taken as dS. So dA into dS gives you volume into specific weight, that gives you the total weight of the fluid element, all right? And also the forces which are acting on the fluid element are the pressure force. So here you can see at one end of the fluid element, at the entrance of the fluid element, so the pressure force which is acting is taken as P into dA. In a sense, the pressure is force by area, right? Our pressure force is equal to pressure into area. So pressure is P into area is dA, right? P into dA is the pressure force which is acting at the one end of the fluid element. So at the other end of the fluid element, the pressure force which is acting, so we know the concept that to analyze any fluid element will make use of Taylor series of expansion, right? According to Taylor series of expansion, so you can write the equation as there is an initial pressure, right, at the entrance, there's an initial pressure P plus there is a change of pressure. The pressure is getting changed, right? When along with the length, the pressure changes. Yes. So there is a change of pressure. All right. So according to Taylor series of expansion, so there is an initial pressure, that is P, plus there is change of pressure, so that is dou P, along S direction, so that is dou S. So change of pressure along S direction, along the length dS. So P plus dou P by dou S into dS. So that is the change in pressure, I mean the initial pressure plus change in pressure along S direction, along the length dS. So that is the pressure concept. So that is P. So into area. Area is dA. So pressure into area gives you the pressure force at the other end of the fluid element. All right. So and the angle which you know the fluid element made with respect to horizontal is taken as theta here. So that is denoted by theta. So that is the diagram, I mean that is the fluid element we have considered, okay, for the analysis or to derive the Euler's equation of motion, thereby to derive the Bernoulli's equation, okay. So in this, I mean to analyze the fluid element, so they have applied the Newton's second law of motion. So we know according to Newton's second law of motion, so according to Newton's second law of motion, so that is force is equal to mass into acceleration. So here the summation of force is equal to mass into acceleration they have considered. So what are the forces which are acting on the fluid element? So one is the pressure force which is acting at one end of the fluid element, that is P into dA, all right? And one more is the pressure force which is acting at the other end of the fluid element, and one more is the self weight of the fluid element. All right, so there are three, you know, forces which are considered which are acting on the fluid element, right? So one is the, I mean in place of summation of forces, you can see there is a pressure, so that is acting at one end of the fluid element, pressure into area, area is dA, all right? And so P plus dou P by dou S into dS into dA, this is the pressure force which is acting at the other end of the fluid element, all right? So but it is acting in the opposite direction, that's why I have taken it as negative. So there's the negative, okay? So minus, I mean rho dA, I mean gamma dA dS, so gamma is the specific weight, so specific weight into dA into dS into cos theta. So here you can see the self weight, so self weight already we have discussed. So that is rho into g into dA into dS, all right? So that is acting in the downward direction, but it has to be resolved. The self weight always acts in the, I mean, towards the gravity, downward direction. So it has to be resolved. All right. So whenever it is resolved, so it comes in the opposite direction. So opposite to the flow of fluid. Yeah. So the, you know, self weight has to be resolved. So whenever it is resolved, it comes in the opposite direction to the flow of fluid. So that's why that is also has taken negative. So negative of rho g, I mean gamma. Gamma is specific weight. So specific weight is also denoted by small w. So w is equal to rho g, you know. All right. So rho g into dadh or gamma into dadh into, since it is resolved, so it becomes cos theta, all right? So whenever theta is resolved, all right, so along theta, so it becomes cos theta. So that's why here cos theta is written. So cos theta is equal to, so there's all the forces, summation of the forces is equal to mass into acceleration, all right? So mass, I mean, to write mass, so they are making use of weight concept, like weight is mass by gravity. Weight is equal to mass into gravity, right? W is equal to mg. So weight is equal to mass into gravity, or mass is equal to weight by gravity. So here you can see, so mass is equal to weight by gravity in place of m in this equation, in place of m. So they have written W by g. Right, because W is equal to mg, or m is equal to W divided by g. That is what they have written. Okay, so into as the acceleration, right, along s direction. So next, further you need to simplify it. So when you simplify it, so it becomes, I mean, positive p into dA minus p into dA. All right, so into minus, I mean, you need to do the, I mean, you need to move that negative sign inside. So it becomes minus dou p by dou s into ds into dA minus gamma into dA into ds into cos theta is equal to, again, W. So what is W? Specific weight. So already we have written here the specific weight formula, that is gamma into dA ds. All right. So that is what you can write here also in place of W. So that is gamma into dads divided by g, right, into acceleration along s direction. So now positive sign and negative sign get cancelled. So positive and negative get cancelled, and the remaining, so equation you can write as minus dou p by dou s minus gamma into cos theta is equal to gamma by g into acceleration. So acceleration part is there. So acceleration is velocity with respect to time. Since this is for fluid element, so you can write it as dv, right? Differential volume by differential change in time. dv by, so dt you can write. Acceleration is, so velocity with respect to time. So that is what they have written. All right. So and in the above equation, so dA ds they have taken common. And they have cancelled it off. All right, both the side DADS is common and it can be cancelled. So that is what, in place of AS, acceleration, so you can write as velocity with respect to time. That one they have taken as equation one. Okay. So, but we know velocity is a function of displacement and time. Am I right? So, velocity in the sense, displacement with respect to time. So that's why, so velocity, they have, for velocity they have written the equation, so with respect to displacement and time by making use of chain rule. Okay, chain rule, for velocity we can write the equation. So there is change in velocity along s direction along the length ds, okay, plus change in velocity with respect to time, so at the total time dt. All right, so dv is equal to dou v by dou s into ds plus dou v by dou t into dt. So that means, so velocity is a function of displacement and time. So with respect to displacement and time, the equation can be written by making use of chain rule. So after that, this is dv, right? The change in velocity. But acceleration is dv by dt. So they have dividing, they are dividing throughout by dt to make it acceleration. Okay. So that's why if you divide throughout by dt, it becomes dv by dt is equal to dou v by dou s into ds by dt. All right. And plus dou v by dou t into dt by dt. So dt by dt gets cancelled. So that's why they have not written here. Okay. So here they have not written because dt by dt gets cancelled. So that's why only they have written dou v by dou t. Okay. So in the next step, dv by dt is equal to dou v by dou s into ds by dt. What is ds by dt? Displacement with respect to time. So displacement by time is velocity. So that's why ds by dt is been replaced by v. Right? Dou v by dou s into v plus dou v by dou t they have written. Okay. So that one is taken as equation 2. So now you got the expression for acceleration. I mean dv by dt. Just substitute this dv by dt in equation 1. Right? In equation 1, whatever dv by dt term we have, in that dv by dt, okay, you can substitute that equation. So equation 1 becomes now minus dou p by dou s minus gamma into cos theta is equal to gamma by g. So in place of dv by dt, they have written that expression dou v by dou s into v plus dou v by dou t. Right? So in the next step, what is cos theta they have taken? The angle which is made by the gravity, by weight, self weight due to gravity. All right. So here you can see the height of the fluid element is taken as dz. All right. And length of the fluid element is taken as ds. So, and this is theta. So we know cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Means cos theta is equal to dz by ds. So that is what they have written here. So cos theta is equal to dz by ds. All right. So minus, you can substitute that cos theta here in the next step. So minus dou p by dou s minus gamma into cos theta is dz by ds. So that is equal to rho by g is there. You can see here. Gamma by g is there. So gamma is equal to rho g. As I said, specific weight is equal to rho into g. So g and g gets cancelled. The remaining will be rho. You're getting right, gamma is equal to rho g, specific weight is rho g, so rho into g divided by g, so g gets cancelled, the remaining is rho. So and the next equation is dv by ds into v plus dv by dt, they have written as it is. So and in the next step, they have assumed, as I said, while deriving this Euler's equation of motion, there are some assumptions has been made. So in that, one of the assumption is the type of flow is steady flow. There is a steady flow, means velocity with respect to time becomes zero. So in the above equation, they are making dv by dt as zero. Okay, velocity with respect to time has been written as zero. So next equation becomes minus dou p by dou s minus gamma into dz by ds is equal to rho into v into dv by ds, because dou v by dou t is zero. The type of flow is steady flow, right? So and if you move this left side terms into right side, it becomes positive. So that's why in the next step dp by ds plus gamma into dz by ds plus rho v into dou v by dou s is equal to zero. All right, and since throughout there is ds, I mean in all the term there is ds, so throughout you can multiply with ds, and the equation remains same. If you multiply throughout with ds, the equation remains same, and so the ds gets cancelled in the next step. So that's why they have written dp. Understood, right? Dp by ds. So since throughout ds is been multiplied, so ds gets cancelled. The remaining is dp plus gamma into dz plus rho v into dv is equal to zero. So again in the next simplification, so they have divided throughout by rho g. So it becomes dp by rho g plus, you know, gamma by rho g into dz plus rho v by rho g into dv is equal to zero. I mean throughout you need to divide by rho g. All right, so in the next step, dp by rho g plus rho g by rho g, because as I said, gamma is rho g, gamma is equal to rho g. A specific weight can be written as density into gravity, rho g. So it becomes rho g by rho g into dz plus vdv by g, because in the previous step rho get cancelled. All right, so v into dv divided by g remains is equal to zero. This one can be written as dp by rho g plus, again rho g gets cancelled, so the remaining will be dz plus v into dv by g is equal to zero. Or this one can be written as dp by rho g plus v into dv by g plus dz is equal to zero. So they have reordered, right? And this equation is called as Euler's equation of fluid flow. Okay, or Euler's equation of motion of the fluid. So by